Welcome to the Let's Pray podcast. I'm Lee Wilson, and this podcast is a resource designed to bring people together for a special time of corporate prayer with God. This is a space where we spend time face-to-face with God as a church family, as friends in the body of Christ. We believe that corporate prayer draws God's people together, invites His presence to move in their lives, whatever area they focus on in prayer. We believe the Word of God and what it says in Matthew chapter 18, verse 19 and 20. I tell you this, if two of you agree on earth concerning anything you ask my Father in heaven, He will do it for you. And where two or three gather together as my followers, I am there among them. We also believe that there is no distance in prayer. And when the church gathers together corporately in prayer, no matter where they are, whether you're in your car, whether you're on your treadmill, sitting with your Bible right now, having your morning tea or afternoon tea or morning coffee or whatever it is you drink, we believe that the presence of God is there with you in this incredible time of prayer, corporate prayer, and a podcast we call Let's Pray. Today, our topic we're going to be praying on is the prayer of the promises of God. You know, the Bible says in Ephesians chapter 1, verse 3, all praises to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in heaven because we are united with Christ. You know that God has blessed you with everything you need. Right now, as we look in this unprecedented and uncharted territory that we are in this world, never seen some of the things that are happening, whether it's happening in our culture, whether it's happening in government, whether it's happening in our school system, just even in America, there are things happening today in our lives that no one has ever experienced before. But it is important to know, regardless of the circumstances, God has made a promise to us. Matter of fact, He's made thousands of promises to us, and we can find those promises in His Word. See, I'm so happy, and I know that you believe that because that's why you're listening to this podcast today. That's why you've made this a priority in your life, because you believe that prayer will help you to bring together or bring into a reality the promises of what God's Word says. You know, as we get closer to Christmas, which is one of the most exciting and wonderful times of the year, there's something very thrilling that comes about Christmas. There's something promising about Christmas. For some, it's the lights, and some things it's the decoration and all of the traditional Christmas songs. And then, of course, there is the promises or the idea of gifts. But can I say something to you? There's no greater gift. There's no greater promise that the Father has given us than the gift of Christ. He's a gift that we receive not because we earned it. He's a gift that was given to us, a promise from God to us. And it doesn't matter whether you've been naughty or nice, that the promise of Christ, the promise of God is here for you. It's a gift given to us because of God's grace. I want you to think about that today. Receive that gift right now. Just, if you can, close your eyes and just think about how incredible the gift of God is. And think about the promise that God made to you and I. Praise God. Thank you, Father. You know, we don't have to send Him a letter to remind Him to not forget us. As we know in this culture today, we've been taught to send kids, little boys and girls, send Santa a letter so that he can remember who you are and how good you are, and that you've been nice and not naughty, and make sure, you know, you tell him you got cookies for him and milk for him. And, you know, and I'm not in any way trying to slam on Christmas and the traditions of Christmas. That's really what this is not. It's not about that. This is really about us understanding that we have such a great Father, and He always remembers us, and He will always fulfill His promises in our lives, and we don't have to remind Him. What we have to do is just say, thank you, Lord, You know how you let God know you appreciate the promises of His word coming to pass in your life is by you just worshiping Him and giving Him praise. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord God, that what makes this season so promising is the hope of Christ. We thank you, Lord. There is a difference in the hope of the world and the hope of Christ. And today, Lord God, we thank you that we have hope in this pandemic. We have hope in these last days. We have hope in this season that we're in right now, not because of presence under the tree, but because of the presence of God. You see, the world's hope is without certainty. Culture, it's without certainty when it comes to your future and your family, your health and your finances. There's this mindset of wishful thinking. Oh, I wish I could. But can I just say to you, the hope of Christ, it comes from Jesus himself. His birth and his death and his resurrection gives us this hope and guarantee the promises of God. And when it comes to the promises of God in our life, they are overflowing and abundant. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, that your promises are overflowing in our lives right now. Let's just thank God for that. Let's just raise our hands wherever we are. Unless you're driving, you keep your hands on the steering wheel. However, the rest of us, let's just raise our hands and just begin to thank God for his promises. Hallelujah, that they're overflowing and that they are abundant. We thank you, Father, that these are the presence of God is never ending. It's like opening up every present under the tree. Imagine this, every present under the tree, it got your name on it. That's what the promises of God are. You're opening up all of those promises of health and financial blessing and increase and favor and forgiveness, and open up the presence of peace right now. Thank you, Father, the presence of hope. In the name of Jesus, just keep opening them up right now. Open up that present of the promise of God of grace in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. Oh, we give you praise. Hallelujah. Comfort right now. Thank you, Lord. The benefits of healing. Thank you. We just keep opening them up. Every time you spend time worshiping and praying God, that's like opening up a present under a tree that has your name on it. Hope in Christ. It is rooted in our faith and the promises of his word. And today we have that. You know what 2 Timothy, I love this scripture. And 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 9 says, "For God saved us and called us to live a holy life. He did this not because we deserve it, but because that was his plan from the beginning of time to show us his grace through Christ Jesus." The key word here in this scripture is gift. The gift of Christ is a promise we receive, not because, as we said earlier, we earned it, because of Christ. You know what a gift is? A gift is something given willingly to someone without payment. I just want you to think about the most incredible, amazing gift you've ever received on Christmas. You know, I can think about a lot of things I received as a little boy growing up in Houston, Texas, with my incredible family, my mom, my dad, my two sisters, and my two brothers, and everybody opening up their gifts. But I remember time and time again, it doesn't matter how many times I got this particular gift, it made me excited. And that was a Tonka truck. Some of you may remember the old Tonka trucks. They don't do it today as much because everything's the technology of the world. But I remember getting that Tonka truck and being able to push it down the sidewalks of our apartment complex we lived in, and you just push it for hours, it seemed like, for days, and until that truck could no longer be pushed anymore because you've worn out the wheels on the, you've worn it out. It's warped and can't move anymore. And Tonka trucks back in the day, it took a while to get them there, but it was such an incredible gift from God. And that's what I want you to be reminded of today as we wrap up this podcast about the promises of God. I want to pray out with some of these promises. And I believe that these promises, these prayers that you will spend time with, not just in this podcast, but even afterwards. Remembering this will help you to have the greatest, incredible Christmas season and moving into a new year, 2021, like you've never had before. Father, we thank you for the incredible gifts that you've given us. And we pray, Lord God, right now, and thank you for the gift of peace. And Lord God, you promise you'll never leave us or forsake us or abandon us in any time. In the time of need, you will be there. And even, Lord God, there are times that it seems like we can't see you or feel you. We know that you're near. We know your promises are true. And we thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for teaching us to have our hearts to rest in your presence and not be afraid, to not be anxious, but to trust in you. Father, I thank you for the blessing of the Lord, the promise of the blessing. And thank you, Lord, that you work all things together for the good of those who love you. And we know, Lord, that you are at work in our lives. And no matter how we feel or what trouble we face, you are working things out for our good. Say that right now. Lord, you are working things out for my good. Thank you for being a sovereign God who sees the end from the beginning, and you use every situation to bring about good in our lives. We thank you, Father, for the promise of hope. And Lord, you have promised to prepare an eternal home for us in heaven, and where there's no sickness, there is no disease, there's no sorrow. And Lord, we thank you for our future hope. We thank you that we can rejoice despite the circumstances in this world. And we know, Lord God, that the beginning, it may seem like right now that it's not the case. But Lord, we know that there is a life beyond this life. We thank you for trusting us with the blessings of God while we here are on this earth. And we thank you for the future blessings of heaven. We're preparing ourselves for that. But before that happens, Lord God, we walk in hope. We live in hope. We're not hindered. We're hopeful. Hallelujah. We're not hurting. We're hopeful in Jesus' name. Someone needs this promise. Someone needs to pray. Someone needs the prayer for the promise of forgiveness. And Lord, we thank you that you forgive us and you cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And we confess our sins to you, whatever they may be, right now in Jesus' name. And you, Lord, are always faithful to forgive. I want you to know that today, that God is faithful to forgive you. No matter how much you think, you may have not forgiven yourself, but I want you to know today, God has forgiven you. And we thank you, Lord, that we come to you with a repentant heart. We confess our sins to you and we trust you to forgive us. And that, Lord God, we will walk in freedom from our past and walk in freedom from the sins. In Jesus' name, we thank you, Father, for the promise of clarity. Thank you, Lord, that you promise to know us intimately. And we know, Lord God, that your word says you know the numbers on our head, that you know our secrets, and you know us better than anyone that knows us. You know us better than anyone. We trust you, Lord God, for clarity, that you'll give us the truth. You give us direction, that you will guide us on every step, in every situation, in our relationships, in our career, with our children, in our marriage. Lord God, you're gonna give us clarity concerning those decisions we have to make. There's someone right now, you're in the middle of making a major career decision and you need clarity. I thank you, Lord God, right now that you will give them peace, and that everything that seems confusing and the storms that are rising up and all the options that they have, that there's clarity. Holy Spirit, thank you, Lord, for clarity in every area of our lives. In Jesus' name. And finally, we thank you for the promise of strength. Lord, we thank you that you renew our strength each day as we trust in you. And Lord God, that you will teach us to wait on you, and that you lift us up, Lord God, as the word of God says, you lift us up on the wings of eagles so that we can soar above every situation, every circumstance. Thank you for the strength you give us the strength to overcome all the obstacles and all the roadblocks and all of the hindrances that the enemy would try to bring, depression and oppression and just fear and anxiety. Thank you, Lord God. We have strength over all of those emotions, all of those things that are coming against us. Thank you, Lord. There are no rivals for your power, your strength. There's no equal. Hallelujah. You are the creator of heaven and earth, and nothing is too much for you. We declare that. Come on and worship him. Give him praise. I'm getting excited as I even pray this and speak this. I believe that God's power is here, and I believe God's power is real for you. And I believe in this podcast that God has spoken to you and challenged you. And I want to close out this podcast with the book of Numbers, chapter 6, verse 24. And it says that may the Lord bless you and protect you, and may the Lord smile upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord show you his favor and give you peace. And may something abundantly happen in your life for the good. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you for joining us